Welcome back to another video. Hans Troyer here. In this video, I tackle the Black Canyon 100K, which is arguably one of the most competitive ultra marathons on US soil all time. So it's a lot of fun, and I think I put on a little bit of a show. So enjoy, and I realize I'm posting this video about a week later than I typically would, and you'll see why at the end of this video, so just tag along for the big surprise. but besides that, the first few clips are just like me filming my Achilles, because I had some Achilles things going into this video, so that's just for some context. But yeah, so thank you guys for watching, and just enjoy the video. So just for some context, we missed our flight here, so we're not happy. So I have a statement to say.
All right, so I have bad news. We missed our flight. We're stuck in Dallas. The next flight they could put us on wasn't till Saturday, which is after the race, as y'all know. And so we just bought more tickets to a different airline to fly us to Vegas. And then we're gonna rent a car and drive for 6 hours tonight, get there at about 4 o'clock in the morning on Friday morning, and it's gonna be okay. We're gonna keep high spirits. I'm gonna try and sleep in the car, and we have not lost hope. So the more I think about it, the more I think that we missed it because of me, because I went to one of them shops and I bought $8 gummy worms and we missed the flight by 2 minutes. So I just want to get that off my chest. Kind of my fault. I just really wanted the gummy worms, I guess. It's okay.
Made it on the flight. Well, almost. Made it in the line.
Made it on the flight, finally. What time is it? 10:17.
10:17 Central Time.
I'm got Dilito.
Not going on the YouTube video.
Yeah. Just blur it out. Blur it out. So we made it and we're going, and we got a 3 hour flight, so.
All right, we're here. It's been a long night and morning, especially for those two, but they did it. But yeah, now it's like almost 2 o'clock in the afternoon. And we're about to head over to packet pickup and the athlete panel, and we'll see you there. Got these pre-race snacks, getting that nutrition right day before the race. My Chips Ahoy, Cheez-Its, and bananas. I'm getting right. All right, we're at the packet pickup. We just parked, we're walking inside. Beautiful, look at this. Ooh. Ooh, it's nice.
You're a new face for a lot of people here. Can you tell them what race you won recently?
I ran the Bandera 100K.
And how fast did you run the Bandera 100K?
It was around 7 hours and 45 minutes.
You ran really, really fast at Bandera just a little while ago. I'm really, really excited to have him here against the...
I've DM'd a lot of people. He was probably like, oh, that's Hans? That's the guy that's DM'd me asking for advice? but yeah, so I mean, I'm just staying humble with it all and just asking for advice. So that means, and so feel free afterwards. If you guys have any hints or anything like that, let me know. But yeah.
All right, guys, just finished the elite athlete panel. Now I'm doing a little bit of a shakeout run, trying out the Achilles for the first time in like 3 days. Feels okay. I could feel better, but I think it's raceable. So let's get it. Right. Just ate dinner, ate some pizza. We're heading back to our house now, and just gonna take a shower, get my nutrition ready, and we will call it a night after that. So I'll fill my nutrition aid kit and stuff, and then I'll see you in the morning. I'm in a bit of a rush, so I'm not laying everything out. I'm trying to get to sleep. So sorry for the bad shot.
Good morning, race day. It's like 4:45. We're getting ready. Let's get it.
Yeah, I'm back in bed. We were in the car. We had driven like 1 minute and figured out the course was, the race was delayed by 2 hours, so I'm gonna try and get some more sleep. So we'll wake up again and I'll pretend like it's the first time. Round two, we're about to leave again. It's 7:14, hour 45 till race time.
Let's get it.
It took 4 times to film that.
Five minutes till race time. It's a little chilly out. Look at the mountains though.
So say hi, Dylan.
What's up?
What's going on?
It's probably delayed again.
A little cold.
It's a little cold.
We're kind of at the start line.
Kinda.
It's supposedly this race starts in 5 minutes, but the fellas aren't here yet, so
right, well, they're probably 5 minutes. They're opening the gates.
Oh my God.
So they, at the time we saw them, were about 500 meters in.
He's smiling.
He's in good spirits. The race isn't going for 9 minutes now, so let's hope it goes well. We'll see you at the next station.
Go Hills!
We made it to the first aid station. This is the coolest aid station I've ever seen in my entire life. It's a whole restaurant, essentially. So we got about an hour before they come through. Last checkup was, Hans was in between second and fourth, at around the, right before the first aid station, around 7 miles in. So they were going about a 6:49 pace at that moment. So we're waiting on him to come through the first spectator aid station, which will be station number 3. And then that'll be 19 miles in. A little after, and so we'll keep you updated.
Yeah.
just arrived at 8th Station.
Oh my goodness.
Number two that we're allowed at. I know we are. I think we're 8-5.
Something.
But Hans is currently first, and we are hoping to maybe see him in the next half hour.
Yes.
We'll see. We got Hayden in second, and then Livestream just said they're about a minute ahead. They're a minute ahead of everybody else.
Yep.
The pack behind them, so we're going to have him to come through, and we'll keep you updated again. All right, just finished up.
Learning experience.
Yeah.
100%. I was having a lot of fun. I think I was having too much fun in the beginning. Got myself in trouble.
How'd your body feel?
I'm loving it. I need a little reset.
Feeling Bandera?
Yeah, I felt Bandera for sure. Just like small things. Like, my quads were so sore from Bandera. It kind of went in my hip flexor. I felt my hip flexor like 30 miles in. And then my Achilles, as I've been talking about this whole video, wasn't great. But no excuses. It was a fun race. I learned a lot.
Any advice to your old self?
What old self? Like the guy running?
Yeah. Past Hans. 8 hours ago, Hans.
Don't hurt your Achilles the week of the race and not run at all. And so
perfect. Here's the crew. We're proud. We're so proud. We love you, Hans.
So after this, we headed back to the house, and shortly after we realized that I had fallen into rhabdo, so we made our way back to the finish line to get me some fluids.
All right, we're headed back to the race to go to the first aid tent. Because Hans is going in a rhabdo and we need fluids in him, so we're hoping to maybe get an IV. He's crawling around, he's shaking and really nauseous, so we're hoping that this helps. Yeah, health, or in this case, unhealthy.
Thank you.
can barely walk.
All right, give us a small update.
We are still in Arizona, waiting on our first flight. I feel awful. I went to Rabdo last night, and I'm paying for it. Rabdo on top of pain, sore as crap, not a good combo. My kidneys like a cop, and I get sick, and I can't really eat or drink, so... And then got that going for me. About to go sit on a plane for 4 hours too. It's gonna be great. Yeah, I'm whooped. I feel awful. I'm sitting in a handicapped chair right now. It felt so bad for me.
The boot is on for the Achilles.
We'll be back. Don't you worry. All right, that is it. Thank you guys for watching the video. And as you saw in the last few clips, the big surprise was I got rhabdo, and the first few days didn't seem super intense, but this is the big surprise. It was intense, and I'm coming to you from my hospital room. So yeah, I went to the hospital because my kidneys weren't doing super well, and I've been here about a week, so you can see all this extra weight on my face. It's just a bunch of fluids getting pumped into me. And no worries, I'm gonna be completely fine. I'll make a full recovery. My kidneys will be just fine. I just gotta be more careful in the future races, which I definitely know how to be more careful. I've already looked into it a lot this past week on what I did wrong, and I know that I did a lot wrong. So it won't happen again, so we're all good. But yeah, so that was the big surprise ending. I can do the almost died YouTube thing, but I won't. So yeah, thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and I can't wait for the next adventure. And thank you guys for all your support. I highly appreciate you guys, and stay young and fit. Till next time.